This presentation shows you where to find HSC science examination documents on the NESA website so that you are familiar with all the available advice. It highlights important information about the exams. This is a summary of the key information. More detail will be provided throughout the presentation. In the two-unit science examinations, there are no options in any of the exams. This is a major difference between the pre-2019 exam and the current exam. The application of working scientifically skills will be examined. At least two items will be worth 7 to 9 marks. Previously, at least two items were worth 6 to 8 marks. Science Extension has an online examination. Schools will be required to upload their students' scientific research reports because the students may be asked to refer to it in an exam question. Schools must ensure that the lockdown browser provided is installed and that students are familiar with the processes and functionality of the online platform. Key documents, including the syllabus, equipment lists, and sample examination materials, are available on the NESA website. Use the Year 11, Year 12 tab at the top of the NESA website homepage to navigate to the Science Learning area. On the Science Stage 6 page, scroll down to see the 6 science courses. Choose the relevant course and click on the Go to Syllabus button. This is where you will find all the key documents for that course, including the syllabus. This format is the same for all science courses. On the Syllabus page, you can download the PDF or Word version of the syllabus. Continue scrolling to see the links to all the exam support material, starting with the assessment and reporting document. Below that are the sample HSC questions, relevant formulae and data sheets, and the exam equipment list. This is also where you can find the principles that NESA uses to set exams. Support materials, including guides to the new syllabus, are also provided. All HSC exams are developed by committees of practicing teachers who are selected based on their experience in teaching the course. NESA has a set of principles for the development of HSC exams. These are the guiding principles that exam committees use throughout the exam writing process. They have been applied since NESA first used a standards referenced framework in 2001. For example, this principle states that an exam will test a representative sample of the syllabus. This approach minimizes the predictability of questions. The working scientifically skills are the same for both years 11 and 12 and are the same across all sciences. These skills may be tested explicitly or as applied in a scenario. Only syllabus content and outcomes can be examined. Textbooks and teaching resources are not examinable. The assessment and reporting document includes school-based assessment requirements and the exam specifications, which are on page 10. They detail exactly what the requirements are for each exam, including structure and timing, question types, the number of questions, and the mark allocation per section. Year 11 course is assumed knowledge for the Year 12 course. This means that Year 11 course content forms part of the knowledge required for students to demonstrate a deep understanding of Year 12 content. For example, homeostasis is a conceptually challenging topic in the Year 12 course. Students who have a solid understanding of the structure and function of cells, the nutrient and gas requirements of both cells and organisms, transport systems, and the concept of structural, physiological, and behavioral adaptations to the environment, all covered in Year 11, will have a fuller understanding of the Year 12 topic, homeostasis. Thus, students may use knowledge gained from their Year 11 course to strengthen their responses to HSC exam questions. Sample examination materials show different ways that exam questions may be asked. The mark values and sample answers provide an indication of the extent of response required. Sample answers demonstrate the minimum response required to achieve the maximum marks. For example, if a question is worth 4 marks, the sample answer will reflect the minimum requirement to achieve 4 marks. Sample questions may be used as models for practice questions in the classroom or for the development of formal assessment tasks. The annotations explain more about the questions. The exam committee determines the number of lines according to the demand of the question and the mark value. The number of lines combined with the mark value gives students an indication of the anticipated length of a response. The number of lines is not standardized. For example, not all 4-mark questions will have the same number of lines. It is also important to note that student responses are not limited by the number of lines provided. Students are able to ask for more paper if they need it. There is an additional package of sample questions, marking guidelines, sample answers, and syllabus mapping. Students need to be aware of the equipment that they require for the exam. It is important to remind students that these special items are required. There is a list on this page that also specifies what students cannot bring into the exam. Relevant data, formulae sheets, and the periodic table are provided for chemistry and physics students. A geological timescale is provided for earth and environmental science students. These are found under the sample examination materials located on each course page. Any other data or formula that is required to respond to a specific question will be provided in that exam question. The Science Extension exam will be undertaken online. The format of the exam is described in the examination specifications found on pages 12 and 13 in the assessment and reporting document. The student's scientific research report that is uploaded to NESA is an exact, clean copy of the report that was submitted for the school-based assessment. This means that there should be no teacher feedback or other annotations on the report. Students will need to have headphones, as questions may include audio stimulus. Students are able to experience an online exam by doing the Science Extension Sample HSC exam. This will enable students to familiarize themselves with the format and functionality of the exam and test the equipment they will use during the examination. Information about the Science Extension online examination is available on the link shown, and instructions about uploading the report are available on schools online. As Science Extension is an online exam, different equipment is required. A lockdown browser must be installed on the laptops or computers that will be used during the exam. Information regarding IT specifications and installation procedures is available on Schools Online. In summary, in the two-unit science examinations, there are no options in any of the exams. The application of the working scientifically skills will be examined. At least two items will be worth 7 to 9 marks. Science Extension has an online examination. Schools will be required to upload their students' scientific research reports. Schools must ensure that the lockdown browser provided is installed and that students are familiar with the processes and functionality of the online platform. These resources provided to help you prepare your students for the HSC exams are available on the NESA website.